back, lacerating the power, me proud beauty. Marry me.
Never.
What? You refuse me? Marry me or I'll tell you limb from pieces.
I'd rather die in terms of the fertilizer. You, the viper.
What? I can't control my blood pressure. Bring on the wood and make a fire. Cursed.
Yes, I, Junior. They're not. I'll grab the rat.
My hero.
Why? Quick, where, when? I see nothing but wind.
What's this, a dream? Why, no. No, it's our hero.
Marry me, girl, and take a load off your feet. If you still refuse me, my oriental blood is boiling. I thirst for revenge. Where's my matches? Give me a match. Give me a match before I go mad.
Why, there's no torch. It's like me.
My wrath is subdued. Curses, it won't work. My wrath is aroused. I could strangle a grape.
Junior speaking.
Curses. Bring me my smelling salt.
Don't overheat my Roman blood. Hold still so I can shoot you. The gun's got a dropsy. Oh, I'm ruined.
Saving men.
Stop, or my bowie knife will cut you.
Curses.
Oh, good gracious. The rat has eaten the handle off.
Tear into pieces, men, but save the hat.
It's my feet. Stop. You forget I am a ball player. Strike one and 4 yards to go, folks. My little sugar plum, Judas, your heavy date has saved you.
My hero.
One pull and you are free. Press into my arms and kiss me, my sweetheart, my angel, my darling, darling.
What the man?
My sweetheart, my angel, darling. And like the wind, they skipped as two fairies. Then rode towards the setting sun of the western skies, which they loved.
This stuff is terrible, son. I'm surprised that you're writing such worthless trash.
Not so worthless, Dad. That book has sold 50,000 copies up to date. The public eat it up. They love it.
It makes no difference. The way you write makes people think that our West is a heck-raising, rip-snorting wilderness. Well, it may have been in the days of 49, but your stuff should be up to date.
Don't let it get you, Dad. It's all in fun. I'm selling what I'm writing, and I'm making money. My public get a big kick out of it.
Well, just the same, it's all wrong. Any real Westerner would laugh.
Read it.
Dear Mr. Morris, I am an admirer of your books, but I think you really do not know the West. If you will come to my mystery ranch, I could show you real he-men who will make the cowboys, sheriffs, and posses in your novels look like sissies. Please accept my invitation as a guest at Mystery Ranch and learn about the real West. Sincerely yours, Mrs. J.H. Henderson. Why, that woman's gone crazy. Anyone who thinks your stuff is tame must be nuts.
What do you think of it, Percy? Do you think she's spoofing me?
Of course. If she implies that Western life on a ranch is wilder than in your novels, I should say she'd have to go some.
Well, there might be something in it. You never can tell. I might get material for a new story. Anyway, I'm going to see what it's all about.
You mean you're going to fall for that woman's letter?
Sure, Dad. A writer has to try everything once. But she's coming with me, aren't you?
Delighted, Bob, but perhaps it might be a bit too wild.
Take a wire to Mrs. Henderson.
About the real West, Bob Morris.
Well, this is a break. Now all we'll have to do is advertise that the famous Bob Morris likes your ranch. Yeah, we'll have all the dudes looking here.
You said it, Sam, and believe me, the idea of getting this rider fellow down will be a lifesaver to us.
He'll like it.
What if he finds out we're putting it on for him and gets sore? Then what do we do?
Never mind, Mary. I know these riders.
Yeah, he's probably some dried-up shrimp from the city that's never seen any Western life outside of the Chicago stockyards.
I guess you're right, Sam. Judging from his looks, he certainly must think the West is wild and wild.
We'll sure give it to him, good one.
Mr. Morris, meet my daughter, Mary.
How do you do? This is Percival Jenkins, my secretary.
How do you do?
How do you do? And George, my foreman.
Howdy.
And
howdy.
Sam.
Glad to know you.
Well, we might as well be going.
All right, Sam, get the bag.
Yes.
Haven't you got a little short step ladder?
Just put your foot in there. You'll be all right.
Put him there. Wait a minute.
Wait till I help you.
Come here. Oh, wait. My goodness.
Try fall. Look out.
Knocking me off the horse and doing
well,
everything.
Get on him yourself.
Oh, this is terrible. This is terrible. I don't know what I'm going to do. Say, wait for me. Wait. Wait.
Just a minute. I'll do this myself.
Well, Jim, have you got anything to say before we turkey into kingdom come?
Boys, all that I've got to say is I hope this is going to be a lesson to me.
Reckon you'll get your hope, Jim.
Are they really going to hang him?
Certainly they will. He well deserves it, too.
But they can't do that. It's against the law, you know.
Remember, Mr. Morris, you're in the real West now.
All right, boys, there's a rip. Hey!
Just a minute. Come here, Bill. I want to ask you something.
Oh, all right.
Jim's a little peeved.
Why, what's the matter with him?
Oh, guess he's a little bashful or something, but he don't think it's fitting for no stranger to butt in on his necktie party. Allows he's entitled to a little privacy.
Is this rope good and strong?
Seems Jim's getting rather exclusive.
Shucks, Miss Mary, Jim never was a good mixer. But no offense, stranger. Better luck next time.
Oh, giddy up. The old rein's loose.
I'll fix it.
No. I'll fix it myself. You wouldn't know how. We sure put it over on the back side.
Somebody was mugging with the off rein. It might have started a runaway.
I'm very much obliged to you for stopping the team, Mr. Morris.
Oh, it was nothing. Anyone could have done that.
Oh, no, they couldn't. Why, it took a very good acrobat to do a Roman ride the way you did.
Oh, well. You see, I used to do an awful lot of sitting up exercises at the YMCA. Yeah.
Yeah!
game.
Thank you, Mrs. Henderson. Thank you for the hearty welcome, boys.
Can't you stop them?
It wouldn't be right to interfere. It's an old feud.
But they'll kill each other.
I reckon they will. But our West is still a free country, Mr. Morris. Good hands are hard to get. Well, Percy, didn't you enjoy your ride?
I've got blisters all over my...
Percy.
My feet.
Come on, Mr. Morris, I'll show you to your room.
You'll have to be all right, old boy.
Well, Mr. Morris, you're a priestess all right. What's your trailer?
Wilbur. And this is Sears and Roebuck.
Come on, Corral. I've got a horse picked out for you.
I hope it's gentle.
Gentle? It's a cross between a lamb and a rocking chair.
This will do the trick, all right.
He'll get the right feel of the West from the ground up.
You said it. Here he comes now.
Good morning,
honey.
Well, there he is, folks, all dressed up and ready to go.
Well, the best horse on the range. He ain't very sexy, but he's smart.
Good.
I guess this is what made the horse so smart.
Why, I can't imagine how that happened.
You certainly are a wonderful rider, Mr. Morris. Where'd you learn to ride so well?
Merry-ground. Trying to catch gold rings.
Henderson, a couple of cattle thieves got away with a bunch of steers out of South Pasture.
Well, we better go after them.
Yes, sure.
Coming along?
They're trying to keep me away.
see they're coming. Now, remember, the boys will separate, and we'll try and get the tenderfoot alone. We'll haze him a bit, but no rough stuff. That's order.
I get you.
You go that way, Mr. Moore. We'll spread out and surround them.
Good.
We sure put it over on him, didn't we?
We sure did. Let him go.
That rider fellow's going to ruin two of my best cowboys.
He sure will, George.
I got him! I got him! You owe me cattle thief, sir. Stealing a lady's horse. Get away, cattle. I'll teach you a lesson.
Howard, did you see them running when they saw you all coming?
I hope they're cured.
You sure can handle your lips and everything, Mr. Morris.
Oh, I get in some occasional practice with dumbbells, you know.
Dumbbells?
Yeah, and the YMCA, you know, dumbbells.
Why don't you just take a little ride over our range before dinner?
Fine. We need some exercise to work up an appetite.
Now, over there, you'll find some mighty good-looking country.
Thanks. Come on, Percy.
What's the idea of sending them off that way?
I want to talk to Sam and Pete. They'll sure want to quit after the rough way that fella's handling them.
Isn't it a wonderful country, Percy?
Wonderful. Wonderful. Look. There's a holdup.
Don't be silly, Percy. That's another one of Mrs. Henderson's gags. I bet they'll throw the body on the roadside and cover it with a tree. Was I right?
But Mr. Morris, perhaps the man is actually hurt.
Now, don't you see, Percy, that's just what they want us to think. If we react on it, the lack will be on us.
I'm beginning to see this tomorrow.
I'm glad you got it. I'm glad you got it. Let's go back and have dinner.
Righto.
Yeah, maybe it's conservative, too.
Tomorrow, how do you like our ranch?
Very well.
It's a nice, quiet place.
But not too quiet to suit you, I hope.
Well, yes, no. Personally, I like lots more excitement.
Do you really mean that?
Of course, being your guest, I shouldn't say it. But here we are, a whole hour after dinner, and not a thing has happened.
But this morning, wasn't that enough excitement for you?
Oh, well, what's a little thing like a lynching or a runaway? Or a feud, chasing wild horse thieves in the morning for excitement? It doesn't go very far. Now, does it?
No, I guess not. You're way ahead of me.
Listen, Mary, I've... may I call you Mary?
Yes. Yeah.
Why, I've heard that in Red Dog, Arizona, they've had at least 3 lynchings a day, 5 saloon battles, 4 holdups, and a couple of sandstorms, and a big range war going on all at the same time. On the other hand, there is a great compensation for lack of excitement around here.
Oh, I'm so glad. What is the compensation?
You. You know, I could easily get used to the place just...
If what?
If I had a little encouragement.
But I'm afraid that wouldn't be at all exciting.
You'd be surprised.
Oh, Mary! That's Mother. You'll have to excuse me.
We can't do a thing without the proper tools.
Well, then we'll have to start walking. There ought to be a ranch house around here someplace.
Wait a minute. Don't you think we're taking an awful chance?
Oh, we'll bluff it through. Come on, get the stuff.
I tell you, we'll have our hands full trying to figure out excitement for him.
Just think of it. And I took him to be some dried up shrimp from the east. Well, we started it, so we've got to go through with it.
He's a smart Alexander, that boy. Half the time I think he's kidding us instead of us putting it over on him.
Do you think he suspects anything?
I don't know.
Well, I've got a couple of stunts up my sleeve, and if they don't click, I give up.
Oh, I wish we'd never started this business of kidding him. So nice about it. I hate to go on like this.
Not a word about the whole of business we saw before dinner. Nice and peaceful around here.
Yes, it's all nice and peaceful before dinner.
Would you like to look at our family album, Mr. Morris?
I'd be glad to.
May I look too?
Yes, sit over here.
Oh, thank you.
Now, this is my grandfather. He taught Teddy Roosevelt's Rough Riders how to ride.
He did.
And this is my great-grandfather. He was the last man to stand at Custer's last stand.
That's too bad.
While over here is my great-great-grandfather. He taught Buffalo Bill how to shoot buffalo. Poor granddad. He was scalped by the Indians.
That's too bad. I suppose this great-grandfather was scalped before he got a chance.
They took my car and bullion and left me laying by the wayside.
Did you recognize them at all?
No. They were just a couple of cowboys.
Now don't pay attention to the bag. Act as if there was nothing in it.
That's a good idea.
Come in.
Oh, yeah. Our car's stalled down the road a ways. We'd like to get some help to tow it in so we can fix it.
Certainly. George, give the men a hand.
Give me a bag.
Order,
Sonny. It's as good as done. Come on, boy.
Mary, will you help me with dinner? Pardon me, please.
Surely.
See, those are the same fellas we saw pulling that fake hold up a couple of hours ago.
Yes, I wonder what they're up to.
Well, I overheard Mrs. Henderson mention a while back she had a couple of stunts up her sleeve.
Whatever she meant, they're in on it.
You think one of us better stay here and watch the gold?
No, the less attention we give it, the less suspicious they'll be.
I wonder what's in it. Say, this couldn't be heavier if it were filled with gold.
Gold? No doubt.
For the love of Mike, it is gold. Gold bullion.
Perhaps it's a fake, too.
It doesn't look like a fake. It certainly has the weight. I think it's real. Listen, Percy. Fake or no fake, we'll put one over on them. And a good one so they won't forget for some time to come.
Oh, what are you going to do?
You stay here. I'll be right back. No fake. I don't want to take any chances with this bullion.
What's it all about?
You're going to be the lone wolf. I'll hold up. Take the bag and the girl to the abandoned cabin we passed this morning.
You remember where it is?
Perfectly.
And wait for me there. Then I'll come to the cabin and do the grandstand play.
Wonderful.
Show them what could have happened.
And if they can do any better, they'll have to show us.
It'll teach them a lesson, as that man said when he was about to be lynched.
You've got everything straight?
Everything.
Now remember, from now on, you're a highwayman. Put it back where it belongs. Back way. And when I get the crowd in here, why, then you come in, see? Now here. Now don't forget to disguise your voice. And don't get nervous.
I'm not nervous.
Here. Come on.
Here we are.
Well, here we are. This will need a surprise.
I think we're going to enjoy this.
Yeah, this is well, what's all this going on around here?
I was hoping you'd hear me. Just a little thing for hard-working boys. And ladies, of course. Here's to those that wish
it
well, and those that don't, can go
to hell. Don't anyone move. I have the house surrounded by my men. Stand back, or I'll shoot. You're going with me, I said. Don't anyone move for the next 10 minutes. Remember, my men are watching you. One move, and all is lost.
Wait till I get a hold of that highwayman. Hanging too good for him. A fine country this is. Nothing but horses and robbers. What you people need is a he-man or two to clean up this bunch of crooks running loose. Wait a minute there, you.
Well, why?
Get out off that horse.
Why?
Get out.
Well, this is an outrage.
Sam! Oh, that is Mr. Jenkins.
Yeah. He and his writer friend framed this holdup as a joke on you and your mother. I heard them.
So that's it, is it? But what's in the bag?
It's only scrap iron.
Yeah. I guess that was part of their joke. Now listen. One joke deserves another. Let's put one over on that writer fella.
But how'll we do it?
I'll tie him up. And when your friend finds you, you tell him that you were held up by a real bandit. You get it?
I got it. Good joke on Mr. Morris.
Well, that it is.
Then what will we do, Sam?
We'll ride to that deserted cabin at the border and hide out. He'll have a tough time finding us there.
All right. That'll be a good lesson from Mr. Morris.
And in the evening, we'll ride back to the ranch and give him all the big laughs. I've got a rope.
I'll stick around and show you a thing or two. Let's go after them. Here we are, everybody.
I want these two birds. Come on, Miss Mary.
Oh.
held up the Lone Star Mine messenger this morning, nearly killed him, and took his car. And they got away with nearly $30,000 in gold bullion.
Why, my secretary and I saw the whole thing. We thought it was a fake.
Well, it was no fake. It's the only real holdup we've had here in 10 years. Where did you hide that bullion?
Why, son, Bandit held us all up this morning, took my daughter and the bag with him.
Well, that was Percy, my secretary. We painted it as a gag to get back on all the kidding we've been getting since we came here.
What is this, a crazy house? Your secretary has it now, eh?
No, he hasn't got it. That's another gag of ours.
Gag, eh? Well, let me tell you, young fella, it's no gag with me. If your secretary hasn't got it, where is it?
Right here. Back of the chair. We put some scrap iron in the bag to make sure that the gold bullion wouldn't get lost.
Still another gag, eh?
Why, I can't understand.
Well, I'll tell you something you will understand. I'm going to hold you until we find that bullion.
But sure, you don't think that I stole it.
I don't think anything, but I'm going to put you in jail.
But listen, I told you the whole thing was meant for a joke.
Well, our jail is no joke. Put the handcuffs on it.
Put your hands out there, mister.
It's getting a little thirsty. You have another glass of water?
Just about an hour. Come on. Let's get out of here.
That's a couple of horses.
All right, come on.
That we're out of that mess, what are we going to do?
We'll take no more chances. We're heading straight for the border.
Why?
Well, where's Mary?
A real bandit held us up, took the bag and missed Mary.
Which way did they go?
That way.
What's the matter? What are you laughing at?
The joke's on you. One of the cowboys came along, explained our plot to Miss Mary, and then they went to the border to hide out and turn the joke on you.
This is no joke, Percy. We've been double-crossed. That wasn't scrap iron in the bag. It was real bullion.
What? But, Mr. Morris, how about me? How about untying these ropes?
Listen, Miss Mary, I hate to double-cross you.
But what do you mean?
Well, that bag over there is filled with real gold bullion, and I'm going to take it with me across the border. And I'm going to take your horse so that you have to stay here. And by the time they find you, I'll be safe.
I do. Well, this is a piece of luck.
Go to the old border cabin.
But you, before you go, untie me, don't say. Don't let me here. Why, untie me before you go. Untie me before you go.
Your men, Sheriff.
Get on the boys.
Here's your bullion. Sam will tell you all about it.
Come on, right, put the irons on him. Get you.
Is it still too quiet and peaceful around here for you?
No. It turned out to be plenty hectic. But I've got enough material for a new story.
Oh, are you going to write me in it?
But the heroine must fall in love with the hero.
Well, are you going to be the hero?
Oh, untie me, untie me.